Now let's get into some real talk. It's time for story time, everyone. Why don't we just dive right on in? Hey guys, welcome to my channel. So for this video, I thought what we would do is we would do some more fun quizzes. These are some BuzzFeed quizzes. And instead of mostly general knowledge, they'll be more personality-based or opinion-based. So you're going to just find out a bit more of my thoughts and opinions and things like that. There'll be a bit of trivia involved as well. But this will just be more of an opening eye to see kind of where my brain is and what I think sometimes. But why don't we just dive right on in and get to some quizzes. All right, so for our first quiz, we have people love to argue about whether or not it's gross to refrigerate these 30 items. So let's decide who's right. So is it gross to not refrigerate ketchup? Yes or no? Yes, ketchup needs to be refrigerated after opening is what I think. And 82% of people agree as well. Is it gross to not refrigerate bell peppers? Yes, they need to be refrigerated. No, bell peppers do not need to be refrigerated. I believe they do need to be refrigerated. 73% agree. And I'll tell you why. I used to work in produce, in the produce department at a grocery store. And bell peppers are literally on the rack where it's cool. They're not in a bin somewhere in the middle of the aisle usually. So that's why I think that they should be refrigerated. Is it gross to not refrigerate your peanut butter? No, peanut butter is not refrigerated. Most people agree with that. What about almond butter? I don't use almond butter, so I don't know. But I'm gonna say no. I feel like it should though, but most people agree. Is it gross to refrigerate onions? No, I don't think so. Onions don't need to be refrigerated unless they're cut. 65% of people agree. I bet you they were torn on whether the onion was cut or not. Is it gross to not refrigerate grapes? Yes, grapes should be refrigerated is my thought. 85% agree. And that is because, again, produce department, grapes were in the fridge area. Is it gross to not refrigerate pickles? Yes, you need to refrigerate pickles. No, you do not need to refrigerate pickles. I believe you should refrigerate pickles once they're opened. If they're unopened, they don't need to be refrigerated. And most people seem to agree. Is it gross to not refrigerate tomatoes? No, tomatoes should not be refrigerated. Yes, tomatoes should. No, tomatoes don't need to be refrigerated. See, I'm the minority here. But again, produce department, tomatoes are not in the fridge area. Just saying. Is it gross to not refrigerate bananas? No, bananas don't need to be refrigerated. And I'm glad 94% of people agree. Is it gross to not refrigerate nut milk? Yes. Okay, is it gross to not refrigerate honey? I'm gonna speed through these a bit since there's a lot. No, honey doesn't need to be refrigerated. Is it gross to not refrigerate eggs? Yes. Okay. Is it gross to not refrigerate butter? Yes. Opened wine? Yes, it should be refrigerated. Hot sauce? No. 50-50. If it's opened, I think it should be refrigerated. Lettuce? Refrigerate that boy. Yes. Apples? No. Oranges? No. Potatoes? No. Syrup? No. Barbecue sauce? Refrigerate that, yes. Herbs? No. Again, it depends. Is it gross to not refrigerate coffee grounds? No. Instant coffee, right? I don't know, I don't drink coffee that way. Eggplants? No. Interesting. No. Bread? No. Avocados? No. Interesting. They're unused though. Interesting. Mustard, refrigerated. Yes. Liquor, no. Liquor. Limes and lemons, no. Interesting. Again, They're not in the fridge area. And mayonnaise. Yeah, refrigerate it. All right. Well, that was just some opinions about refrigerating produce and stuff like that. Why don't we move on to the next quiz? So for our next quiz, everyone has a superpower that comes with an unfortunate side effect. Take this quiz to reveal yours. So which animal do you most identify with? We have a deer, an eagle, a lion, an owl, a panda, a shark, or a wolf? For me personally, I identify with a lion. Where would you rather live? The beach, the city, the country, the desert, the forest, an island, the mountains, or the suburbs? For me, it's between the city and the forest. Probably the city, though. Which career would you want to have? An ASL interpreter, a color consultant, a food photographer, a forensic investigator, a fragrance chemist, a pet fashion designer, a robotics engineer, or a voiceover artist? It would be between voiceover artist or forensic investigator. I'm going to go with forensic investigator. Which course would you want to take? Beginner Dungeon and Dragons, how to be an ethical hacker, how to stage a revolution, impact of graffiti and street art, magic, religion, and witchcraft, surviving a zombie apocalypse, the art of modern feng shui, or the history of famous jingles. Ooh, there's a few good ones here. Oof. Modern feng shui. Which vacation would you want to take? Discover the life of pharaohs in Egypt, experience wildlife in the Galapagos Islands, explore prehistoric lakes in Bolivia, hike the glacier trails in Switzerland, learn the art of the ninja in Japan, live in European royalty in Scotland, take a coffee tasting tour in Colombia, or take a 5-star cooking course in Italy. Ooh, I want all of these. It's between these three, probably the 5-star cooking course. Which supernatural creature would you want to be? A genie, a mermaid, a nymph, a siren, a succubus, a vampire, a werewolf, or a witch? For me, probably be between a mermaid and a witch. And I would go with witch. And finally, what are you most afraid of? Darkness, death, failure, germs, insects, judgment, loneliness, or rejection? Wow. For me, honestly, I'm most afraid of death. And there we have it. You have the ability to hear other people's thoughts, but they'll be able to hear yours as well. It may sound tempting being able to know what others are thinking, especially during a first date or job interview, but how would you feel if the situation was reversed? Would you really want to hear other people's thoughts if it meant inviting them into yours as well? You can try to clear your mind, but that's likely much harder than it seems. Interesting. That's an interesting superpower and side effect. I don't know if I'd want that. I'd have to think about that more. But why don't we move on to the next quiz? All right, so if you can get less than 4 out of 7 on this 2000s cartoon trivia, then you deserve to have your 90s baby card revoked. So I'm a 90s baby, I was born in 92. So let's see. What's the name of Scooby-Doo's best friend? Is it Shaggy, Velma, Fred, or Daphne? It is Shaggy. Correct. Who wants to steal the Krabby Patty formula? Is it SpongeBob, Sandy, Plankton, or Patrick? It is Plankton. Correct. What is the name of the dog that lived with an older couple in the desert? Clifford, Spike, Polka Dots, or Courage? It is Courage. Correct. What's the name of the bunny in Looney Tunes? Bugs Bunny, Lola Bunny, Daffy Duck, or Tweety? That's an obvious one. It shouldn't just be for 90s kids. That's Bugs Bunny. Correct. Where is Dexter's secret laboratory located? In the garage, in the backyard, under the house, or in the kitchen? It is under the house. Correct. What's the name of Timmy Turner's teacher in The Fairly Odd Parents? Is it Mr. Puff, Denzel Crocker, Miss Frizzle, or Miss Fowl? It is Denzel Crocker. Correct. And finally, which kids enjoyed a never-ending summer vacation? Jimmy, Carl, and Sheen? Billy and Mandy, Phineas and Ferb, or Danny, Sam, and Tucker? Is it Jimmy, Carl, and Sheen? No, it is Phineas and Ferb. Never watched Phineas and Ferb. So I got 6 out of 7 correct. You're truly a 90s baby. I hope this walk down memory lane was fun for you. It actually was. Why don't we move on to our next quiz? All right, so if you want to be a Disney adult, you shouldn't break a sweat answering these 10 trivia questions. Let's find out. To start, when did Disneyland originally open to the population? 1950, 55, 65, or 60? 60 or 65? 55? Correct. Can you name the fake Disney attraction? Indiana Jones's Adventure, Star Wars Rise of the Resistance, The Twilight Zone Tower of Terror, or Peter Pan's Adventure? Star Wars Rise of the Resistance, that or Peter Pan? Star Wars. Peter Pan's Adventure. Darn it. Okay. True or false? Club 33 is located in Tomorrowland. I think that's false. I think it's in Americatown, isn't it? Correct. Which country doesn't currently have a Disney park? Japan, China, France, or Spain? I know Japan and France do. I think China does, so not Spain. Correct. True or false? Walt Disney World opened before Disneyland. That is false. The California one opened before the Florida one. Which castle calls Walt Disney home? Walt Disney World home. Which castle calls Walt Disney World home? Sleeping Beauty's Castle, Cinderella's Castle, Castle of Magic Dreams, or Enchanted Storybook Castle? I think it's Cinderella's castle, but it could be wrong. It's probably not. But it is. Thank goodness I got that right. How many happy haunts reside in the Haunted Mansion? 555, 777, 999, or 1313? Is it 999? Correct. Ooh, upside down nines make sixes. What was Pixar Pier previously named? The California Pier, Disney Pier, Magical Pier, Paradise Pier? Paradise Pier? Correct. True or false? Walt Disney World is the largest theme park in the world. I believe that is false. It's true. Interesting. And finally, do you know what Disney bounding is? Using everyday clothes to dress like a Disney character, wearing a Disney costume from your local Spirit Halloween, going to visit Disney, or Disney what? It is using everyday clothes to dress like a Disney character. Because fun fact, and I know this one is true, you're not allowed to dress up in costume at Disneyland or Disney World. It's against entry. So what people do is the Disney bound, basically wearing everyday clothes that you would wear at a theme park, but themed around Disney characters. And I'm correct. So I got 8 out of 10 right. You're the ultimate Disney adult. Magic must be your middle name because you live, eat, and breathe the Disney life. You probably still miss your annual pass like the rest of us. I haven't been to Disney World. I've never been to Disneyland. I haven't been to Disney World in quite a long time. I think the last time was Hollywood Studios, aka MGM, back in the day. And I'll have to go again at some point soon, hopefully. Why don't we move on to the next quiz? Keeping with the Disney theme, everyone is like one of the 7 dwarves. Here's who you're most like. What is your strongest personality? Dependability, communication, goal-oriented, creativity, openness, extroversion, adaptability, or loyalty? Strongest quality? I would say, loyalty. Choose a music genre. Jazz, blues, country, classical, pop, rock, opera, metal. For me, it's pop. Who's your favorite Disney princess? Tiana, Aurora, Snow White, Pocahontas, Cinderella, Ariel, Belle, or Jasmine? How dare they not have Mulan? Out of these ones, though, it would be Pocahontas. Choose your favorite color. Orange, purple, yellow, blue, pink, green, red, black. For me, it's green. and choose a late night snack. Popcorn, Skittles, potato chips, grilled cheese, ice pops, mixed berries, no bake cookies, or bite-sized macarons. For me, it is popcorn. So my character is happy. You are very bubbly and bright, and you're pretty much always the social one among your friends. You are the most friendly and cheerful of the bunch. Your gleeful attitude prompts you to giggle quite often, which only just brightens the mood more. Aw, well, I appreciate that. I appreciate being considered happy. I do appreciate that. I guess I have the rosy cheeks to go with it a bit. Why don't we move on to our next quiz? All right, there are four types of villains in this world. It's time to find out which one you are, going from happy to evil. Where is your evil lair? In the forest, in a cave, in a field, in a haunted house. It would be in the forest. What do you do for fun? Scare people, haunt rooms, perform magic, or wander about? I would probably scare people. Who's your evil sidekick? A raven, a cat, a snake, or a fox? Probably a cat. More witchy vibes, I guess. What color would your soul be? Blood red, pitch black, faded gray, or deep blue? For me, it would be deep blue. What's your signature look? A white dress, a red cloak, a dark suit, or a green dress? Ooh, I think a red cloak would be nice. And lastly, what type of magic do you perform? We've got dark magic, herb magic, tarot magic, or crystal magic. For me, herb magic. So I would be the good character turned bad. You're exactly the opposite of a redemption arc. There used to be some good in you, but for whatever reason, you have now joined the dark side. Don't worry, it's more fun here. Okay, well, we do our final quiz. All right, so here are the top Bob's Burgers debates, and I want to know where you stand. All right, let's see. For those that haven't watched Bob's Burgers, it's an animated show similar to Family Guy and Simpsons. And I really enjoy the show. So we've got Bob, Linda, Louise, Tina, Jean, or Teddy. So it looks like it's more of a pool. For me, I love all of them, but personally, I love Linda. And Louise is the number one, and then it's Linda. Interesting. I do love Louise too, though. Who's your favorite? Who's your least favorite character? Mr. Fron, Mr. Shrill, Fish Odor, Miss LeBon, Jimmy Pesto, Tammy, or Millie? Personally, for me, I don't like Jimmy Pesto. And the majority agree with me. Who wears the pants in the relationship? Bob or Linda? It is absolutely Linda. Most people agree with that. Who's your least favorite couple? Mr. Frond and Gail, Bob and Linda, Hugo and Linda, or Jimmy Jr. and Tina? It would be Hugo and Linda. Yeah, people agree with that. Favorite episode? An Indecent Thanksgiving Proposal, See Me Now, Christmas in the Car, or Larger Brother, Where Fart Thou? I would probably say Larger Brother, Where Fart Thou. Interesting, most people think it's an Indecent Thanksgiving Proposal. I could see why, though. And who would you rather have as your best friend? We've got Zeke, regular-sized Rudy, Jocelyn, or Andy and Ollie. I would have to say Andy and Ollie. They make me laugh the most. And regular-sized Rudy is the most popular one. And that was interesting. So there you have it. Those were just some fun BuzzFeed silly quizzes. I hope you guys enjoyed and answered along with me with the ones that you could answer. And let me know down in the comments below who you would have chosen for some of those Bob's Burgers and refrigerated products quizzes that we took. And let me know if any of the answers that I gave for my personality ones kind of surprised you. All right then. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye!